of draws last night. $500 going out to a lot of great people. And you could be one of them, but the only way to get in is if you pay to play. So make sure you get in with those 50-50 tickets. As mentioned, we're about 5 minutes away from getting the party started with our grand entry, so make sure you get a good seat. There's still plenty here. And for those of you around the grounds that can hear us from the announcer's booth, get yourself set up and sorted as we are not too far away from rodeo time.
Show me what you do now. We don't have to go on.
RC's Letterbuck Challenge. And like we've been doing on all performances, we welcome the flags to lead in our grand people. You take a look at it, the Canadian flag with Lauren Clausen, the BC flag carried by Katja Wagner, and our SRC flag with Kate. With that, we're going to roll in Mr. Sims. Chuck, why don't you bring those great people in with you as the B&T Ride's been doing so every night for us. Brian Sims, Chuck. Possible. We first of all want to recognize our directors of the Smithers Rodeo Club, our president, the hardest working president year round, it is Jill Storing, our vice president and arena director. We want to say hello to Mr. Derek DeHoo. We also want to give a shout out to our treasurer and timed event manager, Sarah Haggett. On the secretary side, we thank Nicole Whedon. We also appreciate our director of the SRC and manager of the BVX in Jan McCleary. A big shout out as well to our director of the SRC and vice president of the BVX. We thank Mr. Charlie McCleary. Harry Holden, the director of the SRC and the BVX. We also give a shout out to Bonnie Volk, director of the SRC and the BVX as well. Our directors, we thank Travis Holden, our arena maintenance man, Nathan Dillman, our outgate over at the Coast Mountain GM side, Wendy Perry, our director, official photographer as well. We thank Dale Hagen, our helping out at the time event end. We also thank Alicia Larson, director of the Beer Gardens and bartender. We thank Tanya Coles, another director of the Beer Gardens and a bartender. and some great directors as well with Katya Wagner, Bob Mackey, and we also thank John Hagen down at the Strip and Shoot for keeping things flowing that way. A special thanks goes out as well to all those that worked so hard all weekend to make everything happen, and they were the newest and brightest bringing that Thursday night show. That's right, we got to give a shout out as it goes to the team of Shaylin Groot, along with Lee Groot, Tiana Hooker, Katya Wagner, Lauren Clausen, David Wernley, Colton Brown, Pat Steiger, our office assistant, along with Kate McCleary and her son, Bo. We thank them so much. Oh yeah, you can give a hand. We'll take a moment for that. These are the people that sit behind the scenes 365 days a year to bring you the great show that we have here. Of course, that is not all. We want to recognize our volunteers that have shown their commitment year after year. Huge thank you to Dale Roy over in the Beer Gardens and our best peacekeeper around. We also like to thank Margot Groves, our SRC best ticket seller of 50-50 tickets for over 20 years. Sinead Cunningham and the crew from Coast Mountain GM for rocking the sales of the 50-50 tickets as well. They help Margo and the team. Hey, huge shout out to that team. We'd also like to thank Sarah Chalmers. As the daughter of the president, she has been an amazing volunteer that was voluntold since day one. And with her is her daughter, is Myla, the upcoming runner for the SRC. Oh, Kayla Chalmers, also a granddaughter of our president that runs for everyone that absolutely needs her. We also thank Emma Whedon, our beautiful national anthem singer, the multi-talented man, oh man, I just get so revved up when she goes to singing. We also got to thank Amanda Wilson, Dorothy Webster, along with Blake Nibb, Stephen Williams, Savannah Olson. How about it for everybody involved, fans? These are the members, directors, and volunteers of the Smithers Rodeo Club, and without them, none of this would be brought before you. Well, fans, at this point in time, I ask you all to take a moment with me as I get that honor and pleasure once again to lead you in an invocation and lead you in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we pause at this time, mindful of the many blessings you've bestowed upon us. We ask, Lord, to be with us in the arena of life. We as cowboys do not ask for special favors. We don't ask to draw around the shoe-fighting horse, to steer the won't lay, or to never break a barrier. We don't even ask for all daylight runs. We do ask, Lord, you'll help us live our lives here on earth as cowboys in such a manner that when we make that last inevitable ride to the country up there where the grass grows lush, green, stirrup high, and the water runs cool, clear, and deep, they'll take us by the hand and say, "Welcome to heaven, cowboy. Your entry fees are paid." Well, fans, at this point in time, I'm going to turn things down below to the beautiful singing talent and the very talented Emma Whedon to lead us in both the U.S. and Canadian national anthems now.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets were dead, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that
Emma Whedon and his four performances. I'm blown away every time. Fans, why don't you celebrate her along with all those in the wagons one more time. Oh, as they make the exit at this time, we draw you over to the Eagle Vision video big screen as we're going to go to firing it up and moving on to what has transpired over the weekend. Fans, gear up and get ready as this may be the final day, but don't be settled yet as we're going to have some good times today. Worldwide. Earl calling the entire group. Our pickup man. Don't forget, tomorrow we're back here again at 2 p.m. We're going to have that letterbox challenge that is going to happen. You can see some of the teardown happen in the arena, but it's always a pleasure, and we always look forward to seeing you next year. But don't forget, it is from. Video for bringing it to us, but it has come to that time. We're going wild, we're going western. The Canadian Wild Horse Racing Association is here, and this is performance that it all comes down to the marbles as to who goes away a champion. So tell you what, like we've been doing, so we're going to count down from three. The second we hit the horn, they got 2 minutes to get it done. All right, get them ready, Jason.
One, two, three, let them move by! Woo! Come on, purple team, come on, purple team.
Team Black gunning for it. Hey, they were number two coming in. Number two coming in. Team Black is doing it.
Hang in there, buddy. Never mind your hat.
Hey, how about it for the John Verbeek team? They were the number one team rolling in here. And they just piled up Team Pink. Still got a little Wild Western time left. We're about 50 seconds to climb aboard, and here's the deal. Points rolling in. John Verbeek in the yellows. They're at number one coming in, 8 points. Alpahalo's team in black. Well, they're sitting at six at the number two spot, but it's the team of Colton Brown, your Smithers crew. They need you more than ever right now. They're with you in purple. They got to get moving as they're in the number three spot coming in. Number four is that Nicolaisen team of Armstrong in the teal. And then rolling in the third or the fifth place, sorry, it is that team of Ryan Murray. So let's see if we can get any more done up. Well, 15 seconds remaining. No horses caught. Fans, how about to celebrate the Canadian Wild Horse Racing Association one more time?
Hey, Dom. It looks like a yard sale out here. Cowboy hat, vest, cowboy boots, everything. You got your reasons. I got my walls. Still got that feeling hood up.
Well, a huge thank you to our Jane First Aid team that has been with us all weekend. They volunteer their time as a dedicated partner as they are our rodeo paramedics all weekend long. Jane First Aid, we thank you. And fans, why don't you celebrate the Jane First Aid a little bit? Put those hands together. Those are the tireless heroes on the backside to ensure all of our great competitors can continue to compete all weekend long. I'll tell you what, we're going to come back to that song in a moment. The reason for it is we're going to set it up in the rear back riding first, but the numbers have rolled in. We celebrate the Canadian Wild Horse Racing Association as the number one team is going to be that team from Hanna, Alberta. How about it for John Verbeek and Team Yellow? Well, here's the deal today. Today's all about, it's a bit of a rough stock challenge in the sense that we're going to be mishmashing a few different things together. We're going to have some bareback riding, a little bit of saddle bronc. We're mixing the mini bulls, the steer riders, the bull riders. It is going to be a fun little afternoon, and it comes to you courtesy of the Shooting Star Amusements, along with Canadian Tire, the Glacier Electric Team, and Starlight Northern Transportation Incorporated. As our pickup men coming to us. Rodeo, as we celebrated the final stop of the BCRA over two performances, but today this is all about having fun with you on a Sunday fun day. And as we go to it, we are going to find ourselves with one cowboy that has a legendary career that has brought him to this point in time. That cowboy you look at is Jared Marshall, as it says on the Eagle Vision video screen. That is the many, many time qualifier to the finals, many times a champion all over this great land. And Jared Marshall would be the overall champ as it goes the bareback riding this weekend, is the lone one to ride to. He's trying to go on a 3-for-3 this weekend in Smithers, but the only way we do it is with you. So the second we unload and go, you got to get to cheering, firing, and moving as it all goes down. It is the BV Insurance Buck and Shoot we go to. All right, Jared, let's do it again. Jared and the Bob. Oh, an unreal effort. How about it for the veteran, the longtime superstar, Jared Marshall of Prince George? Eagle Vision Video going to throw it back to us. You see that Bulkley Valley Insurance Services chute's going to crack loose. Now you watch Bobby McGee go to set up, but the veteran says, not today, sweetheart, I got you. As he buckles back in, this is we're going to take a look at it. Our pickup men go to escort that bucking horse through the Coast Mountain GM gate. As you look at that screen, those final touches come in, and Jared Marshall's going to slide up on himself. We'll come back to that video in a moment, but hey, fans, tell you what, as you go to it, how about an 85-point score for the veteran? You get a look back at it, that is 85 points worth of how you doing. You look at how those feet are going to beat that horse to the front end every time. The mark out was there. Excellent stuff, cowboy. Way to get her done. Well, it'll move us over to the Colin Brunch's account at Bucket Shoot. Jason, you with us down there?
You know what? That was so exciting to watch. I was so close to that ride.
Right? Wow. You were right in the dirt. You felt every minute of it.
Every second jump, third jump, fourth jump, and fifth jump. Uh-oh. Somebody lost some sunglasses in here.
We're going to be going to Ryan Reed. So Ryan Reed is who we're going to go to as we do a little shift up. Now, Ryan Reed came to us as the number two Saddle Bronc rider of the BCRA, but he comes to us today with a big redemption path before him. The reason for it is he would have an opportunity on Friday night to be a pile of points, but a markout situation would get him in a tough goal. Now, markout is where you have those heels at the front point of the shoulders the entirety of that first jump. Now, we just saw that suitcase-type handle, bareback rigging style. This is the association saddle with the buck rein. Ryan Reed and the Saddle Bronc riding going to have an opportunity now to try and outdo the field as we've been 85 in the bareback. Let's see if we can do it in the Saddle Bronc, too. Here we go. Now he's going to get right down to the wear wires on the ride, but fans, I want to walk you back through that. As you can see, this is where the bronc rein and the measurement comes in, so we're going to go back to a little bit of bronc riding school. Now you see that horse is going to get a little long on him, and what happens is he almost has a little too much in his hand in the sense that he gets leaned over the front of his saddle, and as he's trying to reach with his feet, his upper body is going to reach a little far over that visor as he just about hits the overside of the dashboard. He's going to weather the storm out of the eight, but the scores come in, and we take a look. How about you sit him down at 74 on the ride?
Yeah, so as long as that rein is in his hand, that's all legal, right?
That is all legal.
Stay on that trunk. How's everybody in here today? Hey,
yeah, look at all these great people. You know, I know the heat can be tough to beat, but we're so happy to see all your smiling faces here. It is so good to be in Smithers. It's always a pleasure to get to come up here. You know, it almost seems like it happens too fast. In a blink of an eye, four performances down, and we're getting ready for next year. But fans, we appreciate everything you do in supporting us, and we can encourage you. If you want to be a part of the great team here, you don't be shy about it. You let them know, okay? Now, as we keep moving to it, we're going to find out where we're moving to next. And by the looks of things, we may be going to some bovine variety, which may include the horse riding for today. But hey, why don't we celebrate the bucking horses of the C-Plus Rodeo, hey?
Hey, Dom, you know what? I'm just going to say one thing.
Yeah, let's hear it, man.
I've been to a lot of shows.
Yeah.
And Smithers has, by far, the best crowd action ever where I've all went. And you guys are just an absolutely tremendous this area. Well, thank you so much.
You know, I agree 100%, partner. I mean, when you're packed in here 3,000 strong like last night, we're singing, and we don't even have to continue moving the dial. It is unreal stuff.
You know what, though? It is just, this is one of my favorite roadies to go to every year. This right here.
Yeah, well,
after today, I get to go home to my home pro rodeo. And you know what? You guys all can come down there with me. Let's go.
Just package y'all up. You got room in the trailer. I know you brought the toy hauler, so I might be able to pack a few in there. Well, fans, it is a splendid day that we have as we thank the great partners that bring it to us as well. Our team upstairs with me, we thank Annie, along with Patty, the timers, been with us all weekend. Nita in the background.
You gotta see this. New York, London, Paris, Tokyo, and we got one guy from Smithers right here. Hey, that's all the places. New York, London, Paris, Tokyo, and Smithers. You can't get any better than
nice,
that.
Nice, nice. Nice. You know, Jason?
Yes, sir.
Maybe kind of early, but I'm almost thinking, like, I know we've had a little bit of a pause here for a moment. We almost got to see where that energy level's at. Should we try a little dancing, a little singing, maybe? That's, what are we thinking?
You got it, pal. I'm up for anything you want to do. Oh, let me get over there. All right.
Now I'm just thinking we'll keep it light to start.
Alrighty.
Just gonna go and see. You know, this is the way we've started every one of them, okay? I'm thinking the crowd may have it here. We're just gonna clap, okay? We're gonna clap. Pretty good. You know what? I got one dialed up as we build back to it. I know that our gate man over at the Coast Mountain GM gate likes this one a little extra.
Okay.
I know he likes it a little extra. But fans, as we go to it, we're going to go to the Junior Steers. This is where we welcome on the next generation of talent that is going to have their opportunity to battle it out in front of you. And a few of them have done so already on two performances. This will be their third time to ride in front of the great crowd of Smithers. And as we go to it, Panago Pizza is going to bring us the start of this ride. It is going to be Elizabeth Pahalo, who's attempting to get down into the steel, as we're going to see there. Now, let's break down a little something here. Now, it is going to be the braided bull rope we utilize. And in the steer riding, our steer riders have the opportunity to ride either one-handed or two. Okay, that means you can have two hands inside that rope. Now, that is going to be a little bit of a different style of riding. We're going to have a lot of front-end pull-down. And you really got to use those hips to stay secure. Then as they start to evolve in their career, you're going to see yourselves in the one-handed riding style. That is the evolution of the novice bulls and or the open bulls that they'll move to. For some of our competitors, they will shift into other rough stock events like the bareback and the saddle bronc riding. And as it goes today for Elizabeth Pahalo, she's riding for the big prize and is the bragging rights of our Smithers Letter Buck Rough Stock Challenge. So you get to be a part of her little bragging right opportunity. As you can see on the backside, that is her dad, one of the wild horse racers in Al Pahalo, that is helping her get sorted out. But it looks like we're going to give them a moment. We're going to shift down one as we're going to the Home Hardware Building Center Buck and Shoot, as we are going to go to Try and Rivet as we go one down the way. All right, so now we talked about that braided rope, and we get a good look at Try and Rivet. Now what he's doing is that is gonna be that heat up of the rosin, the pine tar type substance for all you baseball players, that stickum, that grippy stuff. That's where you get that little added extra effect. So now we're gonna see the kid gets two hands in there. Now you notice how he gets help on positioning that rope. Now when you're riding with two hands, you wanna be centered directly over the animal just like so. Now he opens up the hand, and this is where he takes the final wrap on the glove, and then they get the assistant to give that little drag over, and they throw the tail out down the side. Now everybody's got a little different style, but for this kid, it is going to be right underneath as he gets corked over the center of that little steer and or heifer as we wait to see where we're at on the gender side. It don't matter. The bucking is all there all the way as C-Plus Rodeo has been bringing some great little steers. Okay. Oh, and as we see that little buck and heifer go by, you know, Try and Rivet is that try all weekend, fans. He goes an 0-3. Why don't you celebrate a kid who's got a whole lot of try and one of those $1 million smiles?
Long hair.
Are you picking on our fans out there?
Yep, sir.
Hey.
Stand up, sir. Stand up. No, just
it
for
wants
a second.
No part
I
of it.
Hold on. I just wanted to show off this guy's heritage. You know what? I think it's actually Fabio. It is too, Fabio. How did you get here, buddy?
We might have to come back for a lookalike count, but hey.
Yeah.
Let's move down to Jackson Kirk, following in the footsteps of his great family. As you notice, a one-handed riding style. Jackson Kirk is going to have an opportunity now in front of you. And I use the word opportunity because that's what it is each and every day that we wake up and get to do this. And that is the rodeo world that we live in. So Jackson Kirk just about set. Here we go. Driftwood Diamond Drilling's where we start, not where we're finishing. And fast, as he comes to a slide and stop, why don't you put him up for a big one? You don't need any numbers. Don't wait on it. Go to him. You take a look back as Eagle Vision Video gives us a great display of the effort. That kid stays square the entire way. And as they wrap that final corner, it'd be the sliding stop of style that gets them there. As our officials put those numbers to paper, we wait to see how they score them. And fans, how about 70? All right, where are all the ladies in the house? You take a look at the big screen, you see it there, Elizabeth Pahalo. Now, we talked about her a little earlier. She's got an opportunity as we had a change of scenery. She moves from Panago Pete's up to the BV Home Center. And sometimes that's all it takes on a steer, just a little change of scenery, little change of logistics can make all the difference to get a little more comfortable. Now, Elizabeth Pahalo has strung together some rides this year. She looks on to the finals next weekend. We see how she's going to set herself down in this open format today. Now, we just saw 70 points put up from young Jackson Kirk, but Elizabeth Pahalo is going to test it. Re-ride opportunity. How many of you figure that young cowgirl should climb on another? Well, your wish may be your command as we may see her come back. Fans, that's going to move us on down to Lauren Mull. Panago Pizza Buck and Shoot. Now, even the direction on the strategy is going to come into mind. Now, we're sitting over here on a left-hand delivery, and our competitors know the first move is going to come to the left. So that's where the strategy comes in on to how they're going to position themselves. An overcorrection can take you out of the money. But Lauren Moe is focused, determined, and ready. We crack the gate, we go! Fans, he uses the power of the purple on the Sunday, and it's not going to power him up enough for a ride, but we can power up enough to give some consolation, as that kid has been absolutely excellent. Just today, a no-score situation. As you see, the overcorrection, I kind of touched on it when he was leaving the chute. That overcorrection can affect you in a big way. As the kid finds himself down at about the five-second marking, sorry, as I take a look here, it was about 5 seconds when he went down. Going to be just a little shy of that eight-second horn. As we talk about some of the identified rules, that is exactly what we need, is 8 seconds worth of ride time. Now, here's the deal on the bucking side. Our officials down below are looking for a multitude of things. On the bottom side for the animal, it is out of 100 points. We are scoring total 50 for that animal and 50 for the rider and how they react. Out of those 50 points, they look for the buck, the kick, the style, the level of difficulty, and how those animals operate in the arena. The contestant then reacts in a mode of what is going to be how they can handle it in the arena. Now you see Chloe Frizzy, so we get two opportunities with cowgirls to go today. And Chloe Frizzy's got all the right fixings to be dangerous. Well, I'd say the apple didn't fall too far down the tree. Her dad would be our bull riding champion last night. And fans, let's not let her walk out of here with that chin hanging low. Why don't you pick that kid back up? Okay, we got candy going away. Got to go to somebody loud.
Yeah.
While we're making noise, we do so because the Canadian champ is in the house. Junior high school Canadian champion bull rider Tanner Loring is getting set and ready as he's got another power of the pink kind of a day. And it is happening courtesy of the Colin Brunch's account and buck and shoot. Here we go, kid. That kid has been doubling down, and if I took Vegas odds to bet on someone, it is going to be that man each and every time. Not only is he a super talented in the arena, he's one of the nicest kids you'd ever meet. Fans, why don't you give Tanner Lauren a little more as he just rolled one to the edge. He didn't just ride one, he's going to best the field so far. How about 81 points for Loring? Now we just saw ourselves set up with an 81, but as we move down to the far end, it is the JR Overhead Doors Buck and Shoot that we're going to find Mr. Cale Mickelson. Now Cale Mickelson would be chasing his sister in the steer riding this weekend on a couple of performances, but I'm thinking he's playing for a little bit of day money and bragging rights to see who's the best in the truck. Let's go! Getting long, but that's okay. You see the wrap on the tall kid? And how about a spur lick on the back end? Eagle Vision Video is going to give us a little show of what just happened there. I want to rewind it back pretty well to the end of the ride because that kid knew he needed some more points. Now watch this. It gets big and tall, and you can see him just reaching out, staying square, and you see there's a little bit of dip and dive. When they start throwing a few belly rolls on the lead changes, but you watch there, that's where the feet get working. That is where the style points come in. The judges love that stuff. The numbers come in. We're going to set them down at number two. How about 75 for the Pritchard kid? Yeah, you take a good look at cowboy in the saddle. That is Mr. Earl Call. You can see him coaching from the front end. As we thank both him and his brother for the many years they've been the true testament, the crown jewel of the contracting world that has been in BC here. But they brought some world-class buckers all across the land. Many trips to Canadian Finals Rodeo, many trips to the BCRA Finals, and many animals with those accolades to follow. But as we take a look now, there's going to be Avril Kidney matching up with one of their little buck and heifers. And sometimes these heifers got a little more jam than some of the boys do. So when we get to it, Avril Kidney is going to need to make sure that everything's about set and ready because 81 sits at the top of the Canadian champ. But Avril Kidney has one thing behind him that could accelerate him to the top, and that is the grandstand in Smithers, BV Home Center Buck and Shoot. We go to work just like the kid does, all right? as we slide through the Coast Mountain GM buck shoot, or sort of the out gate, I want you to do one thing for me right now, and that is celebrate the bullfighters. As we just saw Cornell Pinchback roll through one, and I've been kind of holding up to give him the big intro, but as the 14-1-4 contracting bullfighters come to us, it is because these are three of the best in the industry, fans. Let's meet them now. As they stand before me a little farther out to the arena, fans, why don't you say hello to Austin Byer. In the red, we said hello to him a little bit ago. Why don't you say hi to Cornell Pinchback. And in the orange, making a return after a tough injury this spring, why don't you say hi to the Unity Man and Mr. Cody Call. And on the back, more bullfighters that come to you courtesy of the 14-1-4 contracting. Well, that'll move us to read right. Same deal, fans. Little Sunday energy to get the party flowing. You see the up and down, you watch a kid go, we could be big, we could be big, oh baby, oh, heads up, heads up, heads up, we got to watch that one back, man, oh man, as we go through that Coast Mountain GM outgate, you take a look, this kid is outstanding, he just about goes out, but you watch him power up. Look at where his feet are. As he gets them back underneath that animal, he gets rocking forward, but he's going to ride through it. He looks like a veteran. Throw it back to about 2004, the Bud Light Cup. Baby, oh baby. Oh, the numbers roll in. Fans, he's going to move to number two. How about 80 points for Wright? Well, we saw Kayle Mickelson, now we go to Claire. She's put up some big rides this weekend. Here we go, fans. Oh, Claire. Oh. Well, that'll suck the wind out of your sails. Why don't you put those hands back together? Zach Cowgirl is one of the best in the BCRA, and she was one of the best this weekend. Fans, an outstanding effort by an outstanding kid.
Hey, Doc, got a couple seconds. I'm over here at the beer garden.
Oh, good. Hey, I can see it. You know, yesterday you said you had like a buzzing hornet's nest over there.
It was.
Yeah, now it's a little quieter, a little more Sunday.
But you know what, though, I found out?
What'd you find out?
There's no hangovers here at all.
Well, that, no.
Not one.
Not one hangover?
You know how you cure a hangover?
How do you cure it?
Stay drinking. They've been doing it all weekend. Oh, hold on. We got one person over here.
Stay in the watering hole. That's what we've been told. Stay in the watering hole.
Exactly.
Hey, well, you're finding our friends that are feeling a little sore today. If you are one of our Buckle presenters, we ask you please come up to the announcer's booth. Any Buckle presenter up to the announcer's booth, please. All right. BB Insurance Buck and Shoot. Jaden Peters. I had the opportunity to meet some of our young steer riders before we started. These are some of the nicest young kids you'd ever meet. You know what? They're as talented as well. This is a building block. If we're talking about building the foundation, this is how it starts. You start over in the sheep riding, you move into the steer riding, and this is the foundation of the rough stock world. Here we go, kid.
Come on, Jaden!
Look at Jaden. Oh. Oh! Fans, he may have come down, but he was riding to be trying 90. Why don't you give him 90 points worth of loving on a Sunday as we take a look back. Now you watch this kid, he's trying to keep up and above, but you notice the overcorrection on that animal is actually going to shift him out of gear. So as he loses the equilibrium, and I dance with him up here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you notice that? I was kind of doing the whole.
I seen that.
Yeah, I know. I was trying to ride him with him, trying to see if we can help the video actually get him to the egg. But unfortunately, it's a buck off. That's the way she rolls, and that's the way the rodeo world goes. But we talk about building blocks, and Jason.
Yes, sir.
You know this. The building blocks are important. These are the crucial moments in the rough stock world to build up these kids' momentum on what could be a very bright future and a big career.
You never know. One of these kids one day will be a PBR event, CFR qualifier, or NFR qualifier. It all depends on how you build this building.
Well, you know, I was thinking back to like 04, and you know what I was thinking of was like Rob Bell from Houston, right? One of the superstars that is put the entire area on the map, and I'm pretty sure for a long time people thought Houston, Texas, but we know darn well it is Houston, British Columbia that he hails from.
Robbie Bell. When you say Robbie Bell, I just go, oh. No, I remember him from way back. Here we go.
We're going to the cowboy named kid. How about it for J.J. West? Fans, JJ's had a bit of a frustrating couple of days. Can you please make that kid feel just a little bit better? That is a tough go. It's two buck offs 2 days in a row, but you know what? It's part of the learning process, as we mentioned. But JJ West, don't forget the name. He may be a country music star. Maybe we'll see him in the movies. You never know. JJ West, love that name.
I got a kick out of it. There's some laughter up here.
Well, that's a fun spot to be. He's in the watering hole. Hey, while we're thinking of it, don't forget 50-50s. Get in on it. Get moving on it. I know we got 10 bucks sitting here. We set it aside. All the leftings that I have for my allowance is going into the 50-50s today. All right. JR Overhead Doors, Buck and Shoot. Going to be Mason Colgate. All right, Mace. Mason Colgate. Ooh. Kids already rode him for about 65. Here we go, Mace. Fans, you can tell that kid's a little bit sore. We're going to walk that back right into the steel. An Eagle Vision video, if you can throw it back to before the ride when he's inside of there. I kind of want to show exactly. You notice how that kick comes out. Now watch. As he comes out of there, he's a little shifted over to that hand side. And as you see, he's going to get flipped over. You watch the tumble happen here. And that isn't the worst of it. What happened was, is prior to the ride, that kid was inside of the steel. And you know when that animal gets moving up inside the steel, his leg would actually catch the inside of the panel. And that's where he's going to be a little bit sore. So fans, can you give what you got left for that kid, put them all together? That most dangerous spot to be is right there inside those bucket chutes.
All right, Dom, we hadn't done this all weekend.
What's that?
We haven't waved once.
Oh, we got to do the wave.
Yes, sir.
I like it. We're waving.
We're going to start right in that line, not like that. Listen, look at these guys. They're going,
hi. Oh, yeah. No, we appreciate you waving. What we're going to do is the wave, though. Jason, you are a conductor in the arena.
All right. We're going to go all the way across, reach up the main grandstand, and all the way to the other end, and we're going to come back.
Okay.
And I'm going to run the whole distance. You think so?
I hope you ate your Wheaties and already, because it's going to be a bit of a marathon for you in the heat.
I can take a shortcut across the arena, though. All right. You guys ready to start this off? One, two, three. Yeah. Just keep going. Don't wait.
Keep going. We got to build.
Way up. Keep going right on through. All right, cross. All right, now come back. Way up.
Beer Gardens, we're coming your way. We wrap.
Yeah.
Hey. That's pretty good. Well, now we see that you can do the wave. I think, you know what, I'm just going to throw it to you, Jason.
Okay.
All right. We're great so far on two nights. Let's see what the afternoon does.
You know what? So good.
Nice. All right, this is a quick one. This is a quick one before we move to our next ride. I just love this one. This one makes you feel so good. Give yourselves a hand. You are the superstar, Smithers. All right, Driftwood Diamond Drilling is where we're going to. Buck and Chew. Going to the left-hand delivery side all the way down towards that big screen. We are going to find Elizabeth Bahalo. Now, a reride opportunity she's found. Now, it is not on the discount to the animal she had provided before her, but the slip is going to provide that second chance. Well, some days they set you up the way they happen. That's just the way it goes. And you know what? She's going to get an opportunity, another bucker. How many want to see her climb aboard a third one? As we go now. That'll move us to Serena Kidney. We're going to next. All right, Serena. Now, our mini bull riders have been with us since Thursday night. We're going to do so again from the call and brunch to the count and buck and shoot. Another great learning experience for these kids. This is where it all comes down to. So what they're learning inside the steel is also the shoot procedure, how to handle the animal. And when it comes to the bovine side, I've kind of turned the phrase to be bovine science. Now, we talk about horsemanship and understanding the animals on the equine side. But when it comes to the bovine science, it is understanding what those bovine creatures are going to do inside the steel and how you need to set yourself up to be as picture perfect on the start. The start is crucial, much like the foundation of a good riding program. Now the tools utilized again, it is that braided bull rope, his Serena kidney is getting those final instructions to make sure everything's set just about right. Now you notice, this is where those riding styles again, either one-handed or two-handed. All right, fans, Serena Kidney's about as close to being ready, so we hope you're ready too, because when we open the gate and unload, that's where we go to work once again. First aid team is some of the best in the industry, and as they are here, we're going to make sure that that cowgirl's okay, as she would take a hoof in a tough spot, as we're going to give them all the time in the world to work to ensure that she is going to be okay. So we give them a moment down below to work. We do have some of the best in the industry, as mentioned, as we thank our rodeo paramedics that have been with us all weekend long in Jade First Aid. Team is going to go through all the precautions to ensure this cowgirl is going to be okay. We're going to make sure she's all right, so we're going to give them all the time they need to work. Fans, we can put those hands together.
I mean, that one over there is really cute.
Don't do this to me, man.
We thank that Jade First Aid team for everything they do on ensuring everybody's going to be okay and all right, and that is why we could not do what we do without them, as they're going to take all those extra precautions to make sure that that cowgirl is okay.
Thank you.
We stay with the mini bull riders. It is Logan Winter. Thursday night, Logan Winters will be the champ. Then be Rowdy McNulty would take two. But trying to dust up for a 2-for-2 for his weekend. It's coming to us courtesy of the Colin Brunch's account of Buck and Shoot. Logan Winter. Here we go, Logan. Here we go, Logan. We thank you so much for the hand that you give. Picked up one win on a Thursday. Buck and Shoot. Gonna be the kid who'd be the champ Friday. He'd be the champ last night. Can he go 3-for-3? Rowdy McNulty is back for a little bit more. Now over at the trailer, this kid was working on his dexterity along with his hand-eye coordination. He's got this cool setup where he's got a wrap around his head and there's going to be a bouncy ball on the edge of it. Rowdy McNulty knows he's in a battle. Fans, he comes down a little early tonight. Can you give him a little more as he'd be a two-night champion here before a capacity crowd of Smithers? Times do you get to ride one, ride two, let alone three? Elizabeth Pahalo with the re-ride opportunity once again. Panago Pizza Buck and Shoot. As you see there, Elizabeth Pahalo. Now, when it comes to strategy, now this cowgirl knows it's about going through the motions and keeping it consistent. It is all about one animal at a time. And as it goes for her here this weekend, she's going to try it for a third time today. You think about trying to recover and reset on the mind side, but she's about as cool as a cucumber as you can get. And as we see our team down below, we're going to try and get everything set for her. As she makes the descent into the steel once again. Okay, fans, following this ride, get those 50-50 tickets ready. We got two draws. There's Elizabeth Pahalo working through it, trying to get things set. Now, when you're inside the steel and that animal starts moving, what's going to happen too is you start getting that rope set about as best you can. And then once they start moving around, it is actually going to deliver a bit of a looseness on the rope. So you might get it nice and tight, good to go. But the second that those animals start to move, it will loosen up a little bit. So the ensuring of getting it nice and tight is one key piece. But the other part about it is, you got to try and do so efficiently and calmly enough that that animal's not going to jar ahead or jar behind. Because that, as we mentioned earlier, the most dangerous spot in the entire arena is right there in the steel. As we see, Elizabeth Pahalo is going to put that hand wrap on now. And she's going to try and grab hold. And she knows the second it's in her hand, she's going to have to get going. So they grab a little extra. And she gets her fingers to grab hold. We're going to move that tail. And you see, that's a different style. Tail going to go to the front. She gets set to move, and fans, final steer rider the entire weekend right here, Elizabeth Pahalo with a third shot and an opportunity. Here we go! Some bad news that comes with it, fans. There's some bad news is she is not going to have a qualified ride, as she would make contact with the body long before the ride was over. So what that means is a disqualification. Would you please give it up for Elizabeth Pahalo, as we're going to see here on the back end of the video. You see her lean right here, she makes contact, and that is going to be right before the 8 second horn, as our officials down below also got the stopwatches rolling. That contact from the body down to the bovine is going to put her into a no score situation as it rolls tonight.
All right, here we go. You got any bull riding fans this afternoon?
You're going to roll that one?
Nope.
I'm going to roll this one.
Okay, go ahead.
Are there any bull riding fans in the house?
Oh, come on. Is there any bull riding fans today?
All right, we got you warmed up. Now we see down there, we're going to have a quick little shift change. They got to readjust that rope. So tell you what, we're going to build back into that one. And in the meantime, why don't we give some money away?
Oh, how fitting.
Yeah. Well, the price is right. Come on down. All right, pink ticket. The winning pink ticket today, $475. It is going to be 118259. That is pink ticket, 118259. On the yellow ticket side, 415 going your way, it is 017334. That is yellow ticket, 017334. As you take a look, it is a yellow ticket, 017334, and pink ticket, 118259. Whoa, we're moving! Ho-ho-ho! Well, Iceman, the bucking bull in the arena, as we see the kid come down. That was Rylan Murphy, who'd be the buck off, as we were handing out some coin. And when you got to get to moving, sometimes you got to shift it up and move early. That is a disappointing feat for the kid, but he comes to us. We thank him so much for the effort as we build into that next opportunity. Thank you. That'll move us to Brandon Loring as we take a look. It's happening down in the Colin Brunch is accounted buck and shoot number 5. Brandon Loring. Qualification to the British Columbia Rodeo Association finals next weekend in Barrier. This weekend played host to be the final stop for all of our competitors for an opportunity at points. And as Brandon Loring starts to move ahead, he starts to take that final wrap. So as the final touches come in, we already know the task we're in. We had a qualified ride 2 times yesterday. I'm thinking we build on it. Difference maker, always the people in the grandstand. Bull starting to charge ahead a little bit. All right, kid. That's where we got a grinning bear. We notice Cody Collins just trying to move that bull around a little bit. And you see him all kind of corked up on the front end of the steel. As we get a look over top, we think that Eagle Vision video team is some of the best in the industry, giving you the inside perspective. And you can see how difficult it is to get that star rolling. All right. Trying to move that bull over just a little bit. You see, leaning on his leg, so he's trying to move ahead. All right, Brandon. We're with you, partner. Heard by Brandon Loring. We can't let him get out of here without a little something from the grandstand. So that there, the snowball of the C plus. As you can see, Brandon Loring gonna get shifted way over to that right-hand side, and it's going to go away from his riding hand. The dominant force going to come away. Here we go, Kenneth Dugan! Ooh. Talk about the hammer coming down. Fans, that kid's gonna go 0 for 3 this weekend. Again, we ask you to put those hands back together in consolation. Clap the hands. This is what it comes down to. Driftwood Diamond Grilling brings us the buck and shoot. Riley Dames. Final chance. Final chance for a bull ride is going to happen right here. As he starts to move ahead, we go to setting that flank strap. Riley Dames going to have his hands full. All right, kid. All right, Smithers. Final chance to go at one this weekend. Kid nods ahead. We go to the wild side. Well, fans, you know what? It is a bittersweet moment. Or that closed the book on it. As we spill the bowls, would you give it up for the C Plus Rodeo once again, the contractor that joins us with some of the best bovines, some of the best bulls, and of course, some of the best bucket horses in the game. And as we make some noise, oh, you see right there the testament to the breeding of over four decades going into what has been an outstanding career. And we look forward to what they bring next, as I know the next generation of Buck and Bulls over at the C Plus is looking about as outstanding as it is going to get. As we go to moving those bovine out of here, we do have some presenting to do to our winners down below. Before we get to that, though, I want to thank our bullfighters once again, Cordell Pinchback, Ryan Jasper, Austin Byers, and making his return, Mr. Cody Call. And Mr. Jason Charters in front of all of you. Jason, the funny man, courtesy of the Bulkley Valley Credit Union this weekend. Thank you so much, Jason, for being with us.
Thanks a lot, Smithers. We'll see you next year.
As we also thank our pickup men to make the exit, Earl Call and Wade McNulty. We thank them so much for all they do this weekend. We thank Roy on the back end of the C Plus Rodeo upstairs with me. We thank Annie along with Patty. In the background, it is Nita. Oh, we thank everybody so much. Our officials down below and Grayson Winters along with Bernie Rivet. Fans, it has been an outstanding weekend. On behalf of the Smithers Rodeo Club, everybody involved, thank you, thank you, thank you. As we're going to do some buckle presentations down below momentarily with some awards before we roll on out of here. We've been informed that all the 50-50s have been collected. Congratulations to the winners. And for those of you that didn't win, hey, you know what? In about 360 days from now, you can try again at the 50-50s here. And we look forward to having y'all back. As we await to see some of the scores to iron it out as to who our champions will be, we'll declare our winners here momentarily. We hope you stick around with us as we're not too far away from the big championship presentations. Thank you.
18 jerseys.